Today I want to talk about one of the two places in the book of Revelation that mentions the rapture taking place. Now, those two places are Revelation 7 and Revelation 14. Today I want to show you Revelation 7. Just to give you the context, in Revelation 6, we saw all the same type of events as in Matthew 24. We see the Antichrist coming on a white horse to conquer. We see wars, famines, pestilence, an earthquake, all the things that are in Matthew 24 and Mark 13. Then in Matthew 24, the Bible says the sun and moon are darkened, and then Jesus comes in the clouds, the trumpet sounds, and he gathers up the elect. Well, as we're reading Revelation in chapter 6, and we see all those same events, we see the sun and moon darkened, we should expect that the next thing we're going to see is the rapture, because that's the order of events that Jesus laid out in Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Well, let's see if it's there. Well, it is there. It's in Revelation chapter 7, right after the sun and moon are darkened there. It starts in verse 9. The Bible reads, "After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands." Look at verse 13. "And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, What are these which are arrayed in white robes?" And here's the key. He says, "And whence came they?" Whence came they in our modern vernacular is, where did they come from? Whence means from where. He's saying, who are these people and where did they come from? Well, if the elder who's showing John these things is asking, where did these people come from? He said, "After this, I looked and there's this huge multitude." And then the elder asked me, who are these people? Where did they come from? That shows that they just showed up. That's why he's saying, where did they come from? Whence came they? They just arrived. Look what the answer is. "And I said unto him, Sir, thou knowest." This is verse 14. "And he said to me, These are they which came out of great tribulation, and have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God, and serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more, neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them, and shall lead them unto living fountains of waters, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes." So there you have it, folks. Right after the sun and moon are darkened in Revelation 6, in Revelation 7, we have a great multitude appearing in heaven, out of nowhere. The elders saying, where did these people come from? And they're so great of a multitude, no one could number them. And the Bible numbers some pretty big multitudes. But the Bible says this is a multitude no man can number. And it was all kindreds, all nations, all tongues, because it's every believer who has ever lived being caught up at the rapture. They suddenly appear in heaven. Isn't it interesting that right after the sun and moon are darkened in Revelation, a great multitude appears in heaven of massive size? It matches perfectly with Matthew 24, Mark 13, etc.